Hallelujah. Let me take a few minutes and preach the word of God. Pastor Mavis and Pastor Mike, please join me here. And I feel the glory of God. I feel the presence of God. And it is the same as coming together as church to celebrate the risen Lord, the one who died and rescued us from hell. Hallelujah. And from the wrath of God, both the wrath of God and the wrath of Satan. Hallelujah. Please, one here, so that we can get close a little bit. This atmosphere is filled with God's presence, and nothing can penetrate. Hallelujah. Man of God and woman of God, I want us to study the word of God. And now, Resurrection Sunday, and I want us to do a little bit study about the mysteries behind redemption. The mysteries behind redemption is simple. And I defined it the other day to be born again is to be reign again. To be born again. To give your life to Jesus Christ is to giving your life to meaningful life. And everyone that is born again or giving him or herself to Jesus Christ become a mystery to the world. You remember Jesus said, we are the light of the world and we are also the salt of the world. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You know what? Man of God, in the beginning of creation, man, God's intention was that man become a god or God here on this earth.
Yes.
That is our mandate, was to dominate and to rule. Man's mandate from the book of Genesis chapter 1 was to our mandate. God gave us a mandate. He blessed us and gave us a mandate. And our mandate was to rule, to dominate. The word dominion simply means all things are yours. Everything is under your control.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The glory of God, the weight of God was upon man. Man, let me put it this way. Man was in the class of God.
Amen.
Man was operating in the class of God because
Hallelujah.
In the image and in the likeness, he made him.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
When you read the Bible in the book of Psalm 82, verse 7, he said that, but I said that you are God. And the reason is because you are the children of the Most High God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Amen.
So man wasn't just an ordinary person or ordinary human being. He was in the class of God.
Amen.
Taking absolute control over the creation of God. Mm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Man was operated fully in the class of God.
Amen.
Because he had fellowship with God. You remember in the Garden of Eden, the Bible said that God visited man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the cool of the day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he also endowed with the divine wisdom. Jesus. You remember that man gave name to everything that God has made. So man was in the class of God, and he was endowed with the wisdom of God. And also man was endowed with creativity, creative potential.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ability to bring something out of nothing.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because he has the DNA of God in the inside of him.
Amen.
Jesus. So man was in the class of God. And untinana onyankopon any man Adam ewo ayonkofa enwumre biara okoni ni konya de ben enkita hudie. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So it was so that was God's intention for man to rule and to dominate. Praise God. Hallelujah. He was in a garden of Eden.
Yes.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I call that place the garden of encounter.
Hey. Garden of encounter.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
That is where God built the throne of man.
Jesus.
Until Satan came with deception.
Deception.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Satan was under the feet. Now share. Adam na yase. He was under the feet of Adam. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And Satan wasn't comfortable. He wasn't comfortable at all. For the fact that man was in charge. You know, sir, Satan, he was thrown out here on this earth through the windows of heaven. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
One back through the womb of a woman. So he was like a vagabond. He was walking here on this earth without proper documents.
Jesus.
It's like traveling to abroad and your visa have been expired. And whenever you hear even bicycle coming, praise God.
Hallelujah.
And Satan wasn't comfortable at all. So he made a decision to bring man from that level to his level.
Jesus.
Through deception.
Deception.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Trying to paint or trying to accuse God to man. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
He has always been the accuser of brethren. So he accused God to man.
Jesus.
Trying to paint God black to man. And the fact that he has always been the king and he doesn't want anybody to come to his level.
No.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You will be like him.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will become like the Most High God, and nobody will bow down to worship the other.
This is deep.
Akadebo Shayatabas. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he confused man until man was able to accept the deception of Satan, that old serpent. So, after man has accepted the deception, to be promoted, but he was demoted. It took him from the clash of God.
Hey.
And now man has become ordinary human being.
Jesus. Mercy,
Jesus.
Lord.
Mercy,
Lord. That is when human being became the order of the day. In the beginning, there was nothing like human being. Because we were not just human beings. We were in the clash of God. We are like God, little one that is taking absolute control over everything.
Amen.
That was God's intention for us. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And we lost all the attributes. We lost everything. The potential, the creativity, the wisdom. You remember when God was coming to visit Adam and said, Adam, where are you? Praise God. They were running away and they were covering themselves with leaves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nia otimi tsu nyankopon. Nyankopon adia wabu nyine dinu. Lost the wisdom, lost the knowledge. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He has lost the spirit of God. The glory of God is gone. And he's now covering himself.
Jesus.
And he said, I was naked. You were naked from the beginning, but it was the glory of God. It was God's glory that covered your nakedness. It was the glory. It was the glory of God. Be careful you don't lose the glory. Be careful you don't lose the glory. Be very careful that you don't allow the enemy to take the glory that is upon your life. Because the day you lost the glory, the day you will lose the glory,
Jesus,
you become the ordinary.
Hey.
It is the glory that carry you and
Michael,
put you at a certain position.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is the glory that command respect.
Hey.
It is the glory that command respect.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And as soon as man lost the glory,
hey,
he has to cover himself. He has also lost the wisdom and the fact is, lives will carry you for only 24 hours. It can take you for only 20. When you cover yourself, hallelujah, with any other leaves, how many days? Hallelujah. Because he has lost the attributes of God in the inside of him. Praise God. He has become ordinary. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And God said, and man has become ordinary. So now the serpent has the ability and the capability to bite, to chase. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To become like a threat to man. And God was looking at man that he has created for his glory.
Hey.
For his glory.
Yes.
For righteousness,
hey,
for creativity,
Jesus,
for empowerment,
hey,
and has lost everything.
Mercy, Lord.
God said, I will give man second chance.
Second chance.
Hallelujah.
I'm loving the word.
The love of God, you see, whenever we preach about God's love,
hey,
is different from ours. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God's love is to give his best to mankind. Oh, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. His only begotten son. That whosoever that believes in him will not perish.
Amen.
Will not perish.
Amen.
Will not perish.
Amen.
But have everlasting life.
Amen.
The Bible says, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Jesus.
Even when we have sinned against God,
my God,
he still loves us.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And he wants to bring man back to himself.
Amen.
And the only way to do it is to sacrifice his only begotten son.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
To share his blood.
Jesus.
To reconcile. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To reconcile man back to him. To give the blood, to give at one, to bring at one. That's why we say atonement.
My God.
To be at one again with God.
Amen.
This is deep. This is
praise God. So Christ, or God gave Christ to shed his blood,
hallelujah,
to bring man back,
amen,
to remove the wall of enmity. Praise God. Between man and God. And for man to return to its original place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the back garden of Eden. Man must return
back
to the garden of Eden. The garden of encounter.
Hey.
The garden of encounter.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So, God gave Christ the sacrificial lamb of God.
Jesus.
For him to be slain. To redeem us back to God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So when you read the mystery behind redemption is for man to return back to his original place.
Amen.
We were created for total dominion.
Yes.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We must look like God.
Yes.
So, to give your life to God is to return to where God created you from the beginning.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
To look like God.
Amen.
I said to look like
God. Amen.
It sounds too big, but that is God. That has always been God's intention.
Jesus.
You see, let me tell you something. Every genuine born again look like Christ.
Amen.
That is why you bear the name Christian.
Hey.
You see, let me tell you something. The word Christian is too deep for everyone that is walking in mysteries and revelation.
Hey.
To be Christian, we have always been defined. But definition and our lifestyle is not the same. It's to be like Christ.
Jesus.
To behave like Christ.
Yes.
To talk like Christ.
Yes.
To preach like Christ.
Yes.
To redeem your fellow human being like Christ.
Ah.
You have the power to break through the stronghold of the enemy.
Yes.
And to bring them back to God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are the light of God.
Ah.
We are the salt of God.
Hey.
we carry as Christians can never be hidden and it can never be buried.
Hallelujah.
No power of the enemy will be able to cover as long as we walk in mysteries and revelations. And we understand the mysteries of being a Christian. Let me tell you something. Whenever unbeliever had encounter with a believer, that is Jesus. You remember Jesus said, as the Father sent me, I have also sent you. And Jesus make a statement. He said, I and my Father are one. Hallelujah. Jesus said, I and my, everyone that has seen me has seen the Father. He said, my Father work and I work. So Christ work and you work. Everyone that has seen you has seen Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You don't have to carry fear.
No.
Jesus.
And timidity.
Not at all.
In your mind.
No.
Because you are like Christ.
Yes.
You have the wisdom of God.
Yes.
You have the mind of God.
Yes.
You have the power of God.
Yes.
You are the spirit without measure. You have been anointed to connect destiny. To bring that thing back to life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give God a mighty clap of hands. Wherever you hear the sound of my voice. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the mystery behind redemption. Let's read this scripture for me, Pastor. Read it for me in the book of Colossians chapter 1 verse 12. That has always been my favorite scripture when it comes to redemptive power.
Colossians chapter 1 the verse number 12. Giving thanks unto the Father which had made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light.
Man of God, that is the mystery behind redemption. He said, giving thanks unto the Father because he has made us
meet
to be meet or to be qualified. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
When the blood of Jesus, whenever you give your life to Christ, acknowledging the lordship of Jesus Christ and accepting him as his Lord and personal Savior, you have been shifted.
Jesus.
From one place into another place.
Amen.
From one belief into another belief.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You have walked through condemnation into a life full of opportunities.
Amen.
My God.
My God. He now qualifies us to be partakers of divine
inheritance.
So, woman of God, man of God, and everyone that can hear the sound of my voice, there are certain things, there are certain things, and there are some blessings, and there are some gifts that it only belongs to people that have given their life to Christ.
My God.
Unbelievers have no access.
This is deep.
He said, divine inheritance. We are talking about inheritance. We are talking about blessings. We are talking about position.
Yes.
We are talking about divine covering.
Yes.
We are talking about protection.
Yes.
We are talking about you being shielded. We are talking about
immunity.
Thank you, Jesus. We call it divine
inheritance.
You see, as a father, I am supposed to, by the time I will end my everything that I came to do here on this earth, and I'm going, I'm supposed to give inheritance to my children.
Yes. Yes.
Such as what? Properties, money,
everything
that I have belongs to my children.
Yes.
You see? So that is inheritance.
Inheritance.
You understand what I'm talking about? But we are talking about divine inheritance.
Hey.
Such as spiritual gift.
Hey,
my God.
Such as spiritual gift.
Hey.
Ability to pray for the sick and to heal them.
Hey.
Ability to see from the realms of God.
My God.
Hey.
Ability to win souls.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Becoming like a bridge. To the ordinary.
Yes.
Becoming like a vessel of God in the hands of God. I'm not talking about money. I'm talking about inheritance.
Hey.
I'm talking about spiritual inheritance.
Spiritual inheritance.
My God.
This is, you see, let me tell you something. These are things that put the believer in a certain class.
Certain class.
The class of that God. We are to bring light into this world that is full of darkness.
Yes.
As soon as the believer appears,
yeah,
all the demons,
hey,
are quiet.
Yes.
Hey.
As soon as
the believer,
hey,
appears,
hey,
all the demons, all the evil spirits, all the witches will run,
hey,
and they will hit themselves.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the power to reign, the power to rule,
hey,
the power to be in charge,
Jesus,
is at work.
Amen.
In the inside of ours.
Yes.
You see, let me tell you something. We have always heard these things. And it looks like we have heard it.
My God.
It is one thing to hear it. It is another thing to manifest.
Manifests.
You don't just hear these things. You are to put them into practice.
Practice.
Let me tell you. I've always acknowledged the fact that my presence in a place bring orderliness,
yes,
and discipline.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes.
I have. That is my mindset. That when things are not going on well,
hey,
and I appear in the city, my presence,
hey,
alone,
hey,
looking at my demeanor and the seriousness at my face.
My God.
Oh my God. Power. Because I am a redeemed child of God.
Yes.
I am connected to a life full of blessings.
Amen.
Full of power.
Amen.
I am operating from the supernatural.
Amen.
I am back in the garden,
hey,
of Eden.
Dominion
is at my disposal.
Hallelujah.
I can't afford to be in a place and see confusion.
Not at all.
And see the enemy at work, trying to kill somebody before their time.
No.
As soon as I appear,
hey,
and by the time I return,
Jesus,
everything will be all right.
Hey.
Because I am connected to divine inheritance.
Yeah.
Let me tell you.
Inheritance.
See yourself. I don't care your circumstances now.
No, but
I'm talking about spiritual things that the unbelievers has no understanding. They don't have it.
My God.
They don't have it. They don't have it. To bring somebody from grave,
Jesus,
back to life,
hey,
is at work in the believer.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And oh yes. Oh yes. Walking in favor.
Hey.
Walking in blessing.
Hey.
Walking in breakthroughs.
Jesus.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
Oh my God.
Ah.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh my God. The world has always criticized the church,
yes,
of us, especially in this end time, that keeping everything for ourselves,
yeah,
because they are not part of us. Look at when this coronavirus, when this coronavirus and it has killed many, look at the impact of the church. Look at the contribution of the churches.
Yes.
Except you are blind. Look at how great men of God are supporting the government,
yes,
with the little money, though there are no services.
Yeah.
Look at the contributing, the economic factor.
Yes.
Very, very true.
Let me tell you, the church, many people don't understand, but let me repeat it. The church is now employment to many people.
Yes.
Amen.
Oh, yes.
Very true.
Even when we are not gathering service, the church is still paying their workers.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very, very true.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Man of God, a woman of God, I want you to read the book of 1 Peter. 1 Peter, chapter 1, verse 3 and 4.
1 Peter, chapter 1, the verse number 3.
And 3 and 4.
Blessed be the God.
He said, blessed be
the God.
And the Father
of our Lord Jesus
Christ,
which according to his abundant mercy.
Which according to
his abundant mercy.
Abundant mercy. Oh God.
Had begotten us again.
He has
begotten us again.
That is what you call being born again.
Yeah.
He has begotten, he has given birth to us for the second time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To everyone that has given their life to Jesus, it means you have been gotten.
Yeah.
Remember Jesus said, except a man be born again. So Peter was talking about being born again and the benefit that you receive when you give your life to Jesus Christ. He said he has begotten us
again unto a lively hope.
Ah, unto what?
I
can even end my message here.
Hey,
he has begotten us unto
a lively hope.
You see, we are not like unbelievers.
Not at all.
That is why. You see, when you see a Christian, everyone they understand the concept of Christianity and being born again. They are not in competition.
Not at all.
Nenim readie. On you being pressure.
No.
Even when we are dead and we have gone back to God, we are going to spend long years, trillions
in heaven.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we don't only depend. We don't only depend on the blessings and the money and the thing that we see with our eyes. That is why everyone that is genuinely born again is content with the little that they have.
Very true.
I'm preaching good.
I'm preaching good.
I'm preaching good.
You are preaching
because
good.
We are begotten into where?
He has begotten us again unto a lively hope.
A lively hope.
By the resurrection.
By
the resurrection.
The resurrection
of Jesus Christ.
Of Jesus Christ.
From the dead.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, we are not confused.
Hey,
we are not looking like ordinary people. Because we have been gotten into a lively hope.
A lively hope.
We have hope. Though I may be poor today,
hey.
I look vulnerable today.
Hey.
But you see, I am born again.
Amen.
And Christ has given birth to me into a lively hope.
Amen.
I look poor today. But look at me for the last time.
Hey.
I am going through certain things. But hey, tomorrow you are going to meet me again.
Hey.
And you will see the glory of God upon my life.
Jesus.
I am a living testimony.
A living testimony.
Every born again believer is a living testimony.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is what we call divine inheritance.
Divine inheritance.
Divine heritage.
Divine continue.
Of Jesus Christ from the dead.
Good.
To an inheritance.
To
an inheritance.
To what?
Inheritance.
Inheritance.
Incorruptible.
Hey.
My God.
Bobo.
Hey.
Into what?
An inheritance.
We have inheritance
that is incorruptible.
If you have car.
Corruptible.
Yes.
Corruptible. If you have money.
Hey.
The same. If you have property, the same.
Hey.
You have visa.
Hey.
10-year visa to travel. Now that coronavirus is changing everywhere. I don't even know you can beg for the father you have 5 years visa.
Hey.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
But we have what?
An inheritance. Incorruptible.
Incorruptible. You were a Japadia intimacy.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
You can take the money, but you can't take my spiritual gift. You can take my property, but you can't take the anointing. You can take the order you are giving to me, but the glory and the power that I carry, and the fact that my name is written, Emmanuel, Mama Yahweh, sorry, is written in the book of life. You cannot go to heaven and erase my name from the book of life.
Hey,
I am fully loaded.
I am fully loaded.
What a way.
My God.
Oh my God. I am what?
Fully loaded.
Fully loaded. Brethren,
anyone
that can hear the sound of my voice, give your life to Jesus. And to give your life to meaningful life.
Amen.
Hey.
Continue.
To an inheritance incorruptible.
Incorruptible inheritance.
And undefiled.
So this is our position.
Amen.
This is the standard between the godly and the ungodly. I don't care how many properties you have. I don't care. I may be walking without a car, without a bicycle. But you see, let me tell you. What I carry, in the inside of me, go beyond just mansions and buildings and cars and husbands and wives and other things. Because I carry divine inheritance.
What a way.
This inheritance can never be corrupted.
Not at all.
And undefiled.
And what?
Undefiled.
Undefiled.
And that fadeth not away.
My God.
Undefiled inheritance.
Yes.
And
that fadeth
it
not
can never,
away.
Can
never fade away.
The color of your skin may be faded.
Masuke deva hasuta.
Beauty can be faded. Can be faded. I beg your pardon. Beauty can be faded.
Yes.
The color of your skin can be faded.
Yes.
It can fade.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your money, your business, whatever that put you in a position that makes you think you are super hero than everybody can be faded away. But you see, when you are connected to the one that cares his entire life and shed his precious blood,
my God,
for you,
Jesus,
you can never be disconnected.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you done?
No.
Are you done?
And faded not away.
Faded not away.
And it is reserved in heaven for you.
Hallelujah.
It is where?
Reserved
in heaven for you.
Our inheritance.
Hey.
So you see, let me tell you something. We are also working in a mindset that when our work here is done, we have a crown. And man of God,
my God,
after this corona season, our message and our focus will not be here on this earth. The success messages and breakthrough messages has come to an end. Because you see, the way we are looking at things, Christ may appear very soon. You see, it has been a long time that we stopped preaching about heaven. Fighting the good fight of faith.
Yes.
And then running the race and receiving the crown that Paul was talking
my
about.
God. My God. My
Hallelujah.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Hey.
Baptism of suffering is not being preached anymore.
Not at all.
Our focus has been money. It's not a bad thing.
Yes.
Marriage is not a bad thing.
Yes.
Success is not a bad thing.
Yes.
But you see, so nipenya sanima winyinara. And you don't make it to heaven, and you're useless.
Yes.
If your name is not in the book of life,
my God,
yam fashuro, and yam opopo, and yam kwaji huwejuma. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Peter was talking about not only inheritance here on this earth, but inheritance that is reserved for me in heaven.
My God,
in heaven.
I may not own a mansion, but may I own a mansion in heaven?
Amen.
This is deep for you, my dear sister. You may not own a mansion, but remember what Jesus said: in my Father's house, there are what?
Many
mansions. We are not preaching. You see, the reason why God has allowed this thing, I didn't say God is the one that created it. He has allowed it. This coronavirus is to teach us lessons.
Yes.
It's to return to the old ragged crossness.
Yes.
The message of the cross.
The message of the cross.
Preaching to people. Making them to know that when everything has come to an end. Here in this earth, we must be able to make it to heaven.
Amen.
We must be able to make it
glory,
to heaven.
Glory,
hallelujah.
Glory,
amen.
Are you done?
Yes.
Are you done?
Yes.
So we have inheritance that is reserved. Hallelujah. Except you give your life to Jesus.
Yes.
Except you have been redeemed.
Yes.
You have been purchased.
Yes.
With the precious blood.
Yes.
You may have mansions here on this earth, but they are temporary.
Ah.
They can be fade.
Yes.
They can be faded.
Yes.
Corruptible.
Ah.
But you see, where you have big estate.
Hey.
I want to own an estate in heaven.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Estate in heaven.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you go back to the book of Colossians chapter 1, and we have dealt with the inheritance.
Yes.
So let's continue with the next one that Paul talked about. The second one. Colossians chapter 1, verse 13.
Quickly. Colossians chapter 1, the verse number 13.
Verse number 13.
Who had delivered us from the power of darkness?
He said,
who had delivered us from the power of
darkness? Giving your life to Christ.
Mm.
Hallelujah. It simply means you have been delivered. You have been break loose.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
From the powers
of darkness.
Of darkness. From the domain of Satan.
My God.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He has no power to control your life.
Amen.
Anymore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have been delivered.
Jesus.
From the power. Deliverance simply means setting, being set free.
Hallelujah.
From a place, from one place into another place.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We have been delivered from the powers
of darkness.
Into the kingdom
of his dear son.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
So you now become an asset. You now become an asset in the kingdom of God.
Jesus.
You now become an asset in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
To become an asset in the kingdom of God is to reign.
Amen.
To become an asset in the kingdom of God is to reign.
Amen.
You have been put into a position to reign and to rule.
Jesus.
According to the book of Revelation chapter 5. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Verse 10. You have been put into a position of rulership. Being a Christian, your name is written in the book of life.
Yes.
You have divine inheritance in heaven.
Yes.
Not only, also to rule here on this earth.
Amen.
To rule.
To
be in charge.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Over what? Blessings. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Success.
Amen.
Breakthroughs.
Amen.
Good life.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Being connected to your destiny.
Yes.
Dreams and visions.
Yes.
Are available today.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Continue. Revelation chapter 5.
Revelation
verse 10.
Chapter 5, the verse number 10.
He said,
and has made us unto our God.
He has made us
unto our
Christ
God.
Has made us through the shed blood. The power of redemption. He has made us unto our God
kings and priests.
And priests. These are two powerful people that are in control over the affairs of life.
Yes.
We are talking about kings that are making decrees. Making decrees at the palace.
Yes.
They are making laws at the palace. And you must obey.
You must obey.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And we are also talking about priests that are also making a law.
Yes.
At the temple.
Ah.
So whether at the palace or at the temple, you are to rule.
Amen.
Hey.
You will be in your bedroom and make declaration into the kingdom of darkness.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will be at the bathroom, at the kitchen, and you will pick your call, and they will give you bad news, and you will send a word into the kingdom of darkness, and your words alone is enough to pull down strongholds. Cast down imagination.
To destroy.
To disorganize. Shout yes.
Yes.
What a word.
You also will be at the palace.
At the palace.
Be at the temple.
At the temple.
And command.
command the blessings of God,
blessings of God,
the breakthroughs of God. Whatever you are believing your life,
yeah,
you are believing
Jesus
for your life,
hey,
that will make your life special, that will make your life look different,
Jesus,
as you decree,
hey,
with faith,
yeah,
because you are to reign,
yeah,
and you are to rule,
yes,
and as you make declaration,
yeah,
within the space,
prophesy,
of 24 hours, they are released,
amen,
into your life,
Jesus,
because we are different kind of people.
Yes, we are different.
Peter said in the book of 1 Peter chapter 2, 1 Peter chapter 2,
verse number 9,
1 Peter chapter 2,
verse number 9,
but ye, he said,
but ye are a chosen generation.
You are a chosen
generation.
A chosen generation. By virtue of redemption. By virtue of redemption. I want to sing you out,
professor,
that in your family, you have been chosen by God. Among your colleagues, among your friends, it has nothing to do with your educational background. You have been chosen. You have been redeemed. Your sin has been washed away. And you have been anointed to bring glory back to your family. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What a word.
Ebra, coronavirus by you. Who see a free politician? Jubilee House to come and debate.
Not at all.
They called men of God.
Men of God.
Men with power.
They called men of God.
Men of God.
The Archbishop. The Eastwood.
Yeah.
The Dagiwa Mills. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Ajina Saris.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
And all the great men of God. Yes. And the chairman of Church of Pentecost and all the great men of God. Yes. They called them together to make a declaration.
Yes.
It is the reason why we have only few people.
Mm. Mm.
Because we were acknowledging the presence of God.
Yes.
Over this nation. So men of God was invited to pray for the entire nation.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We are what?
A chosen generation.
A chosen. We have been chosen by God by virtue of redemption. We have been sanctified. We have been anointed.
Amen.
We have been separated.
Amen.
We are like a vessel, a tool in the hand of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Go ahead.
A royal priesthood.
A royal what?
Priesthood.
Priesthood. A royal. Royal priesthood.
Hey,
don't take me for granted.
Not at all.
A royal priesthood.
Hey,
a chosen
generation.
A royal priesthood.
An holy nation.
Ah,
an holy nation.
A holy nation.
A peculiar people.
Ah,
are you talking about what? Peculiar people.
Peculiar people.
They look different.
They look different.
They look different.
They look different.
Their perceptions are different.
Yes.
I don't care how much you criticize
me. Yes.
The way I look at things. The way I read things. Hallelujah.
Hey.
The way I measure things.
Yes.
Is different from yours.
Yes.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Uh-huh.
That ye should show forth the praises of him.
We are to do what?
To show forth.
We are to show forth
the praises.
You may call it pride and arrogance.
Hey.
If I am to show forth God praises, what do you expect me to be? To behave? I walk like a giant.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't look like a liability and a beggar.
No.
Not at all.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I am like a lion.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The eyes are open.
Jesus.
I have faith in God.
Hey. Yes.
I have been anointed in God.
Yes.
The kingdom of God resides in the inside of me. My behavior, the way I talk, is different from yours.
Yeah.
And your pride.
No.
And your arrogance.
No.
So what is it? Emma Jata Sonri. Woman Jata Mura Sonri. Beba Sonri. And your hand on you Mura. On your punch. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am being operated from the supernatural.
Hey.
I am to talk big. I am to dream big.
Dream big.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
With all humility. I am to talk big.
Talk big.
I am to dream big.
Yes. Dream big.
I am to behave
to behave
like a child of God.
Like a child of God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I am to show forth. Every aspect of my life,
Jesus,
give glory to God.
Amen.
Look at me a little bit. Hear me. Every aspect of your life,
Jesus,
give glory to God.
Amen.
Your old friends must look at your present circumstance, and they thought they knew you at the village.
Hey.
And when they meet you again, you will continue to behave like a villager.
Hey.
Your perception has changed.
Yes.
Your perception, your dilemma, your attitude, the way you speak has changed, because
Amen.
You have given your life a kingdom reside.
Hey.
You are God's permanent residence. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are not a beggar and liability to anybody.
No.
To anybody. To anybody.
Not
to anybody.
Not at all.
Continue.
We should show forth.
We are to show forth his praise.
Who had called you out of darkness.
Yes.
Called you out of darkness.
So the past, the present,
Jesus,
and the future, they are not the same.
They are not
at all.
Oh, I have been able to break out of darkness.
Hey.
My mind is not looking at the failure of the past.
No. Hey.
No way. I have been transformed.
Amen.
Yet do not be conformed, but be ye transformed by renew of my mind. My mind is renewed. I am a success. I am a blessing. I am a breakthrough. Whenever you see me, you see God's glory. I am always smiling, because my mind is connected to success, to destiny, to blessing, to breakthrough. And at the end of the day,
Jesus,
when I am dead,
hey,
and I am going, I am going straight to heaven,
hey,
because I also have